I'm going to talk this morning a little bit about healing. I think there are several things that go into us being able to have a consciousness where healing can take place. So the first is that we come together and in a group experience and worship. You know, I think it shows up in lots of different traditions around the world that, yes, absolutely, you have to do your own spiritual work. You have to do a practice on your own. But there are ways that when we come together as a group that we get accelerated spiritually in ways that don't happen when we do the work on our own. You know, because there's faith in the group. There's a belief and an energy in the group. And sometimes that can lift us and carry us where we cannot go on our own. This is really that principle that's illustrated in the New Testament of two or more gathered in the name of God. I think it's important that we receive ongoing inspiration in order to have healing. So whether you're reading a book or listening to a CD or watching DVDs or TED Talks or something like that, it's important. And I think it's also really important that because we're always in the process of trying to evolve our consciousness, that we be engaged in some kind of spiritual, metaphysical education. Because I think all of these things together help produce healing. Why? Because these are tools that change our consciousness. You know, that we get rewired from the inside out. Now, when I'm talking about healing, this is not necessarily cure. So when people hear the word healing, very often where they go to is cure. Cure. That's it, cure. Make my symptoms go away. Right? And really, the problem with that, and I mean, and I understand totally, you know, when I have symptoms, I want them to go away too. Right? But the problem with that is if we have not made any change in consciousness, then we've sort of missed the point. Because we say if something is so, there's a reason why it's so. So if we're dealing with some symptoms, there's a reason why those symptoms have showed up.